canvas out there. Hey guys, A-Train here, co-casting with Zai. This match in the After Hours Gaming League. This is going to feature Team IBM versus Team Cegeka. Cegeka, I believe, is one of the new companies this season. They are from Belgium. And so a bunch of EU players. So it's good to have them in the league. And this first map is going to be Frost Ali. Spotting in the top of the map is going to be Kenter from Cegeka, the red Protoss player. And his opponent from Team IBM is going to be Thudbang, the blue Zerg.
Where's Thudbang's Overlord going?
Looks like he's going for the directly across the map spawn location, but I believe you can spawn in any of the locations on this map.
Yeah, I don't know if Thudbang doesn't know that or what. I've never seen anyone scout cross with Overlord. Hopefully that's not like standard and I'm being dumb right now.
I think you're right. I think most Zerg players will scout to the east and then north. And unfortunately for Thudbang, it's not going to work out in his case. We don't have any early pool, but we do have an extraction from Thudbang. Looks like Kenter opening with the pylon on the high ground does not mean he's going to go for any kind of early nexus, I don't believe.
Yeah, it's kind of surprising. I thought this map it was pretty popular for FFE still.
A little bit about Cegeka. Currently touting a nice 5-2 record in the After Hours Gaming League. The roster, I have not seen any Diamond or Master players on the EU server. But because this is the After Hours Gaming League, I think anything can happen. These players prepare very well their builds and strategies for against their opponent.
The probe scout in the wrong direction. It'll be interesting to see if he hits the watchtower and sees the Overlord, though. He could change direction if he sees which way it's coming from.
He actually does not pass by the watchtower on the way there, so he does not see that Overlord. Thudbang opening with a pool first. Pretty standard, I think, against Protoss. A very safe opener. Allows you to get the expansion a little bit easier. And he is going to go ahead and expand. No gas, so no speedlings. Do have the expansion for Kenter, so expanding off of this one gateway right now. Probably going to want to make some zealots to go ahead and help defend this in case there are any early Zerglings.
Yeah, this is probably going to be a really late gas for Protoss. He'll throw down a pylon at the natural and then like a forge and a gateway or two more gateways or something. Or maybe not. Cypercore is going down.
Interesting.
I have no idea what's going on.
Interesting to get Cybernetics Core before the gas. Unfortunately, I don't think he will have the 50 to even afford Warp Gate. He definitely wants to get the Mothership Core out as soon as possible, and he's not going to have the gas for that as well. But there he is getting at least one more gas. He may want to take a second as well. Unfortunately for Thudbang, I don't think he has scouted the correct location. I think he's assuming that it is a cross spawn. And this is going to buy Kenter a lot of time. He's not going to be vulnerable to any early Zergling harass because Thudbang has scouted the wrong direction.
Yeah, Thudbang is picking the correct third base based on the Protoss starting spot. So that's good news for him, even though he has no idea where the Protoss is at. Because if Protoss was bottom left, that would be a terrible third to take.
Kenter now knows where his opponent is. Thudbang is at the bottom, and he has not scouted any part of the base, but he is looking if there's going to be a third, which won't happen for a few more minutes. Looks like we are going to be set up for... Oh, he has a pylon. Kenter dropping down the pylon. I wonder if he'll go for some kind of cannon rush. If Thudbang doesn't have his Overlord close enough to this ledge, he won't be able to see the pylons. Could be very effective if he... But he has to make sure not to lose this probe if he is going to go for the cannon rush. I think he's going to end up sacrificing the probe to get some scouting information. But he won't be able to make any cannons on this third, which would have really, I think, helped his position.
Yeah, Thud still doesn't see that pylon. His warp gate's halfway done, though, so if he throws down a couple more gateways, he could just warp units right into that base if he wants.
Right now, just the two gateways for Kenter. No Mothership Core yet on the work. Wait, what is the worker count right now? 30 to 28, so actually pretty even. Both players macroing steadily. And the third is now finished. Unfortunately, nothing here for Kenter to warp in just yet. But he could warp in a couple of zealots once that finishes and start harassing the Zerg player.
A couple of early spores for Thudbang. That's a small victory for Kenter, just because you're getting those two drones basically killed off. And since he's not going any kind of air, those aren't going to do anything for quite some time. Yep. It's not a huge thing, but in close games it can matter.
Yep, looks like Thudbang still hasn't scouted his opponent. And I think he might think that it's still in the top left of the base. He really should send an overlord up a little bit. I don't think he realizes that that these players can spawn at any part of the map.
No, he did send the Ling into the top left if you check his view.
Yes, he has.
And it looks like he's seeing that wall off and stuff. And the expansion.
It would have been pretty funny to see if he went that long the whole game. But nonetheless, getting a lair and getting some roaches, getting the roach worn. We do have the Mothership Core and a few Zealots marching across the map. How many gateways are now finished for Kenter? We have about six gateways, and a Twilight Council.
We might just be seeing some 6-gate blink with a plus 2 potentially.
But Thudbang does scout the forward pylon, the only pylon on the map, and I don't see a forward probe, so it's just now coming out of the base, so I don't think this push is going to be coming anytime soon. Buys Thudbang a few more moments.
Yeah, Thudbang's got a really good economy going. He should be scouting the third right now, and if he doesn't see it, he wants to stop drone production and get either roaches or hydros to supplement his lings. We'll see if that's what he's going to do here.
Thudbang using the Zerg lings to get map control. And as you said, scouting out the third right now.
Charge. He's going Zealot Archon?
Well, he is getting the charge, but he also is getting a Stargate. Interesting build selection from Kenter. We'll have to see how this works out for him. Could be going for the popular Phoenix and Charge Lot play. but I think eventually Protoss will want to get some kind of area effect against Zerg, either Colossus or High Templar, to really help out balance. Right now, Hydralisks for Thudbang, a couple of Evolution Chambers on the way. And if we're looking at the work count, 68 to 47, so he's really looking strong in terms of the macro. And as long as he can go untested here, I think he'll be able to continue and keep his macro up.
Yeah, Kenter's way ahead in tech right now, but Thudbang's economy is going kind of nuts. And 1-1 will help the Protoss a ton if a fair amount of Hydras get out there.
We do have the 1-1 upgrades completed. No upgrades yet for Thudbang, but they will be started. So both players kind of playing a little passively. I think this works out in Zerg's favor, just because of the macro. It's very easy for Zerg to get really high up there because they can make so many more drones than Protoss can make probes. We do have an Oracle on the way, and we have the Templar Archives completed. Kenter does start the Storm. So that's the era that we were talking about. And Thudbang going for the fourth base. Meanwhile, the fly count is now starting to get up there, 150 to 86. And the worker count is 20 worker lead for Thudbang. Looks like he is going to go challenge the third, and going to be met by a bunch of Zealots and Stalkers, and one High Templar. This is an insane amount of roaches. I don't know if Kenter's going to be able to save his third here. He is forced to cancel it, and Thudbang is going to try and approach the front, but I think Kenter will be safe from this attack. Thudbang with no anti-air, this Oracle might actually be able to get a ton of kills here. And it looks like these roaches will get cleaned up. Kenter does not even have to activate the Mothership Chorus Overcharge. And still no Hydralisk yet for Thudbang, even though he does have the Hydralisk then.
Yeah, and he got the Hydralisk range upgrade as well. So it looks like he might be preparing to transition to air, though. He's getting plus one flyer attack.
So what do you think is the best position for Protoss to do right now? He needs to really take that expansion.
Yeah, seeing Mass Roach, you probably want to throw in a few Void Rays and use your Psy Storm on Hydras if they come. He's just way behind in economy right now, though. He does have a fair amount of minerals. He could throw down a few more Gateways and get a ton of Zealots. Zealots aren't ideal units against Hydras or Roaches, though.
Could also try to go for the double expand, but it might be a little bit tough right now. A bunch of Roaches coming in on the south side looking for more expansions. Well, Thudbang's going to be pleased to see that there is none over here. Still, a bunch of Oracles being produced by Kenter. I think he's going to try and harass, but with these Spore Crawlers here, I don't think he's going to be able to pick off too many drones.
Yeah, Oracles melt Hydras pretty quick, but they're also very, very squishy, so if the Hydras focus them down, they die almost instantly.
Thudbang needs to make sure he doesn't get caught in the middle there and have his army split in half.
Yeah, this is a good base design for Kenter, but it doesn't look like it's going to have time to get up.
Oh no, and the Roaches and the Hydralisk going to work on this wall that is not complete, the cannon's never finished. And right now, just charge lots. There's a couple. He does have a couple of high templars. He could get off some storms here. Gets one off. Unfortunately, I don't know if it's going to be enough to hold these Roaches. The Roaches just take so much damage. The storm is not the most effective against them. And it looks like Thudbang might end up getting the third again. So Kenter not able to expand as freely in this game.
Oh, and he size-stormed his own sentry. It's never good.
Meanwhile, Thudbang taking a fifth base on the bottom part of the map behind this. His fourth is finished. He actually has some idle drones that I think he meant to put in the gas. Right now, just macroing behind his economy. Kenter kind of stuck in the middle here. Really, it's the gas constraint right now. You can see the mineral to gas ratio is just almost 6-1, and he really needs that gas from that third base that he just can't get. So he's forced to make nothing but Zealots. Save his gas sparingly.
Yeah, at this point, I'm not sure what the Protoss can really do.
He's trying to use the Oracle to get some drones, but there are Spore Crawlers around. See if he's going to be able to pick off anything. And he actually uses the... what's the skill called? I forget sometimes. so rarely used.
Envision.
The Revelation, yes. Revelation. Ah.
Wait, what?
Revelation is what allows him to see the opponent's view, whatever he's able to get with that revelation.
What the hell's Envision, then? Oh, Envision's a detection one. Yep. I'm good for a toss player.
So Thudbang almost maxed out. Going for the Broodlords. We haven't seen Broodlords a lot ever since Heart of the Swarm came out. I think they've almost been forgotten. People try to... I think they usually go for the Viper instead, since this is a new unit.
No, they go for Swarm Hosts.
And Swarm Hosts.
Swarm Hosts is like a Broodlord, but it's tier 2 and it's faster. So there's really no reason for Broodlords anymore.
But we are going to see some Broodlords. Where are they morphing in? They're at the bottom part of Protoss's base. We have about 8 Broodlords, so those will probably start floating their way across the map. Keep in mind, I think Thudbang is probably more of a Wings of Liberty type of player. We haven't actually seen him build any Heart of the Swarm units yet. We'll just have to see how Kenter deals with these Broodlords. Nothing but Oracles right now, and unfortunately Oracles can't shoot air units. So he might not have anything to deal with these Broodlords. And an unfortunate story for Protoss right now is he is almost mined out at his main base. Only 30 minerals remain, and he has no expansion to put all of these workers. So it's basically going to be 3-1 in terms of active economy.
Thudbang's up to like 4.5 now.
Yeah, the key for Thudbang is getting all that gas. The gas is so important in StarCraft 2. And we have the Bloodlords marching across with Infestors, Fungal Growth. This is totally like Wings of Liberty in my opinion. We haven't seen this in so long. It is being effective here. Some storms go down for Cantor, but right now he just doesn't have the economy to produce an army that will match this. And I think his days might be numbered. Yes, this Fungal Growth and Broodlords used to be so strong in Wings of Liberty. And there's the good game! Thudbang takes it, gives IBM the 1-0 lead, and we will go into game 2.